My name is Juan Acuña. I was born and raised in Tehachapi, California, just up the road here from AVSR.
I really think that solar has been one of the more fun things that I've done in the last decade of my life, only because it's nascent, it's constantly emerging, evolving, and we are literally setting the standards. And so when we look at a site like AVSR, a site that has had this kind of longevity and productivity, and we compare it to things that are happening in the world today, like, you know, sites that are going in over on the other side of Mojave that are huge. The thing is this, we get to see the origins, and as we drive through the Antelope Valley, it's like being in a museum. You can watch the evolution of solar happen from this side of the valley all the way over to the other side. What am I doing? Where am I doing it? Who am I doing it for? How do I go about doing it safely? It all starts with scope. So for example, if I'm going to go work on a utility scale system and somebody says, you're gonna go work at this PV plant that's utility scale system, it's 20 megawatts. Well, I can't just assume that I know what that system voltage is because I didn't design it. So then questions have to be asked in order to narrow that scope. What part of the system am I testing? Is it at the 600 volt level? Or is it series groups of modules, individual modules? At every point of the system, every single level has its own level of hazards. When I choose my tools, it's all about safety and do I have the right tool for the right job? What parts of your body are going to be exposed? What parts of your body do you need to protect? Obviously, because you're connected to the whole thing, you're going to need things like gloves, the proper safety wear according to site rules, regulations, hard hat to protect my noggin, safety glasses to protect these eyeballs, hearing protection depending on what I'm doing, but the right hearing protection, the right gloves, cut resistant sleeves if the task that I'm doing requires it, knee pads if I need to protect my knees, the correct FR gear, the correct FR suit, which all goes back to what am I doing? I think the best piece of advice is to be curious and willing to learn everything you possibly can. I mean, up to and including, first and foremost, the safety. Be willing to learn. You know, going and doing hands-on OTJ or on-the-job training is a valuable thing. It really is. Understanding the theory and finding yourself in a situation where you've got access to the proper training and then paying attention to that training and then holding yourself and those around you to that standard of that training, I think is one of the biggest things that any new person to the industry can do.